Hi. My name is Justin Hall, and recently I lost my wallet. In that hour while I was eating breakfast, someone had yoinked it out of the, you know, an unlocked part of my car. I was stupid. They were off to Walgreens and Starbucks and Safeway and Jamba Juice, buying gift cards and smoothies and spending all kinds of money before I managed to shut down all my credit cards and my debit cards and, you know, order all that stuff again. It's so weird to have somebody else take your stuff and run with it for a little while, but then it was over. Until I got a note from the San Francisco Municipal Transit Agency saying that they'd found my wallet. And I thought this was really amazing. I guess the person who stole my wallet must have left it on a bus or something. So I went to the San Francisco MTA customer service desk, and they handed me not my wallet, but a bag. This is not my bag, but it's got my wallet in it. I received this bag about 4 days ago, and I really haven't been able to touch it, and I thought, I want to film this, because what if this is the portal to an alternate reality game, where if I call the phone number and go to the address and look at what's on the SD card, I can piece together some massive mystery of some narrative that's been put together by some cabal of liberal arts educated game lovers. Or maybe this bag is incriminating evidence in the criminal prosecution of someone fighting for a new world that they believe exists beyond property and capitalism and subjugation through labor and inequality. Or maybe this is a person who was a little bit crazy and has figured out enough of how society works that they can piece together belongings but not hold on to them very long. I thought this was a little weird to see what's inside of it, and I thought I'd share that with you today. So, we have a breathing mask to cover your face. It smells sort of used, but I'm not sure how. We have a package of Whole Foods chlorine-free baby wipes. We have a Ziploc bag of instant oatmeal, True Delights, wild blueberry muffin flavor. We have a Wet Ones antibacterial hand wipes. We have a Amir Argan Oil Moisturizer. It really smells strongly in this bag, but not like this moisturizer. We have this metal tin with a fish on it that has like a ton of earrings and little like chains and things on it. Like really kind of like random stuff. But like not fancy jewelry, like inexpensive costume jewelry. We have this bag which says marijuana on it and has like some sort of like photo gallery pictures on it. Let's see what's inside the bag inside the bag. There's nothing inside the bag inside the bag. It smells more like a high school girl's perfume than it does like a marijuana accessory. There's a pack of cranberry emergency. This is an immune booster, I guess. We have a box from La Ruenda in Costa Rica, which is a tiny little like frog pin for your lapel. Wow, some wild stuff. There is a bottle of Lagunitas Imperial Stout beer. Definitely, I would say the heaviest thing in the bag. There's Speed Stick Ocean Surf deodorant. There's what looks like an empty Hi8 tape case with some, I'm guessing, marijuana stems inside of it. There's a coin purse thing that if I snap it open, it has like what looks like a BMW Mini keychain on a, but no key, on a slack line. And then an infinity car key keychain thing. There's a mirror. Yeah, so now you can see the camera maybe here. I do this right. There's a pair of like hardware store work gloves. There's a honey balm conditioner for dry skin. It smells like honey. There's a glasses case with two pairs of glasses in it. There's a single glove of a fabric sort, Mizuno brand. There's a third pair of sunglasses. There's a charger for Android or Kindle. And then there's something in this pocket I haven't seen. If I can figure out how to get in there. There's a keychain with sort of a dancing figure on it. There's the other glove. The other glove has been found. No, this is a third. There's five gloves in this bag. And two batteries of a D size. And, oh my God, a little keychain thing with a address on it. I'll decide whether to reveal this address or not. A ballpoint pen, a USB charger type device, a portable battery, and finally, there's this metal tin with some sort of funny picture of it, of a sort of Golden Gate Bridge based thing, and inside is nothing except an SD card. So, from Walgreens Photo. So let's check that out. And finally, there's my wallet, which now has a chain on it. So I got a chain out of the deal. This was a wallet that my aunt gave me. It's Stingray. They took a permanent marker and colored in some of the Stingray stuff. Inside the wallet is a Samsung Tactiles sticker, a Restoration Hardware customer loyalty card or gift card. There's my health insurance card, a Starbucks gift card or loyalty card, my California driver's license, and a Golden State Advantage food stamp card, I think, and a temporary ID card for a Whole Foods employee, and a phone number written in on a scrap of paper, plus two receipts. And the receipts are three receipts. Irving Market, Walgreens. Oh, I can see what they bought with my credit card, I think. Yes. Oh my God, this is awesome. Oh, they returned it. They bought a speaker system and returned it. They pay 10 cents for a plastic bag, because that's something you have to do in San Francisco if you don't bring your own bag. They bought a $20 Starbucks gift card. They bought a $32 SD card for 16 gigabytes. And they bought a MyCharge talk and charge for micro, maybe the USB battery. Oh, they spent $125, of which I came away with much of the looted goods. I'm glad to have my wallet back. I feel a little weird that someone assumed my identity for a brief amount of time, but they kept my health insurance card, so my hope is that they went and got some mental health benefits or some mental health counseling. And now I have all this random crap that belongs to somebody else, but sort of belongs to me. Possessions are weird. As soon as I'm dead, who gets to inherit all this treasure I got from the San Francisco MTA customer service this week? I feel kind of intimate with someone else. And they were intimate with me. And it was all non-consensual and at a distance, but in the same city. People like you support The Justin Hall Show on Patreon. Visit patreon.com/justin.